just concentrated on for what you look like. People come up and go, oh, you look better on TV. Oh, you look better in person. Well, I don't know. I'm a female comedian. How good looking do I have to be? Who set the precedent? Roseanne, Paula Poundstone. I win. You know what I mean?
All right, Tammy Pescatelli on Last Comic Standing, one of her many stops on the showbiz circuit. Tonight, she's stopping by the 19 Action News studio. Tammy, thanks for coming in.
My pleasure.
Good to see you. So you're in town for the improv, and we'll get to that in a little bit, but good to be back in your hometown.
Yeah, I'm here for the sports.
All right, well, that's why I wanted you in, because I got to tell you, in this town, if you can't laugh, you'll cry, as we found out.
For sure. This is the town that has the lowest divorce rate because of the sports thing. Because you keep going, maybe next year it'll be better.
No one watching. Hey, listen, you walked in with your Browns button, too, I noticed in your coat.
I do. My grandfather put that button on my coat a long time ago, and I thought I can't take it off until they actually win, so it'll probably be on there for a long, long time.
Listen, I know you're bouncing all over the country doing your thing, and you're in L.A. sometimes and Pennsylvania, but are you keeping up to date on the daily soap opera that is our Cleveland Browns?
My gosh, no wonder they canceled all those soap operas, because we have the Browns to go through it. You don't need all my children.
The Young and the Very Restless, right here in Cleveland. Braylon Edwards. What's your take on the whole Braylon Edwards thing?
He's like a mini T.O., really. That's all it is. It's just a bunch of tantrums. It's, you know, you can't get along with your coworkers. You make $8 million a year. You couldn't keep me from that job.
Now, if you ran into Braylon at a nightclub, I mean, you're from an Italian family, so I think I know the answer to this. Could you handle yourself if he threw a punch at you?
First of all, in my family, I'll tell you what I tell my husband. I don't believe in divorce. I believe in disappearance. So Braylon can't run as fast as my family can find him.
All right. How about the quarterback mess? Were you following this whole thing?
Crazy.
Brady, Quinn, Derek Anderson?
They're all, you know, here's the thing. I love the Browns. I try to teach my husband about the Browns. He's from New York. They have winning teams. We're watching a game, 34 seconds left. He says, you can change it. I said, oh, no.
Like?
Browns can lose a game on the way home from a game. You know, we just can't.
Well, it's been crazy here. You know, Eric Mangini obviously came over from New York.
Yes, nice Italian.
What's your take on him?
I don't want to say anything until let's just wait. Let's give him a shot.
The jury's still out on this?
Here's what I know. At least they're eating well. That's what I know. I know that Mangini's probably having nice pasta meals. We need curfews. I think maybe we need to pay him on a sliding scale, because you go to the game in a Mercedes, you leave in a Mercedes. If you look at their schedule, they'll be driving home with skateboards and ropes.
You know, in all your travels and all your hotel stays, have you ever paid $1,700 for a bottle of water?
Yeah, not save my... That's ridiculous. That, right there shows you that's...
That was the fine. That was one of the fines he levied on one of his players.
That's crazy. What happened to the good old days? What happened to good old Bobby Knight just throw the chair and, okay, everybody duck?
Well,
what
happened
next to that?
Give him time. It's only four games into the season.
That's because we have this wimpy society that they don't want to keep score. That's what happens. These children grow up, we don't keep score. It's everybody's a winner. No, yeah. Some people are losers when they grow up. You have to teach your kid how to...
That's why we keep score here in this newsroom.
Do you really?
Absolutely. That's why you're going to throw a spiral of Tanchak before this show is over.
Give it a shot. You're going to be carrying this around. I said like I dropped
the
pass or something.
The program, Omar Epps.
I feel like a crazy person.
All right, so you go way back to when LeBron was still in high school.
Yeah, I went and saw him when he was in Irish.
Yeah,
Fighting Irish and all that stuff. I grew up here. I remember when the Indians were so bad, cops give you set of speeding tickets, you'd get Indians tickets. You know, I mean, those were the days.
Yeah. I want to remind my producer, by the way, I am not in my usual chair, so if we're getting tight on time, you need to tell me I'm in the news chair, so I don't want to keep you here all night, just so you know.
Really? Because I don't mind. There's a lot of funny stuff that's happening.
Plus, you do 45 minutes on stage. So
right.
This is a blink of an eye.
People say to me, are you a Shaq fan? I said, not only am I a Shaq fan, I have his CD. I was born 3670. I
You're
think
the
it's
one?
On a Wednesday. I know the whole thing.
You're the one
so
that has it?
I know Shaq Fu, okay? You don't know Shaq Fu.
Now, you've acted. I know that. Are you a better actor than Shaq is?
I think Shaq's pretty good. Have you ever seen Kazam? Don't tell me he was sleeping there.
I'm so much older than Shaq that I think I was past that stage when the movie came out, so I never saw it.
Oh, Shaq is... So. He acted like he liked Kobe.
Yeah, well, so he is a good actor. All right. Now, we don't have to just keep to the ball sports or basketball and football. You're quite a historian, too. I mean, you know actually how NASCAR...
It's just my theory. I think that NASCAR started because when guys come home...